Now you find that this is nearly stable. There is still some eddies there, whirling motion of water. But as I am focusing that one, it seems to be very, the motion is very large, but it is not as large as it is being photographed. But it should be as calm as possible. That means the water should be stable, very stable. So now, because this is almost more than an hour, it's operating, so I feel that there is an equilibrium attained and there will not be much improvement. So in case if you find that this kind of motion is still persisting, then what you have to do, you definitely have to have a large number of samples so that the replication which you will be taking, so the next one can be, this thing can be minimized. So that you need to take care of that. So you please note down that there is a whirling motion for this case. So now I am numbering it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so let's say the beaker, these are numbered. So you see, find there is a number 1, and here you can find there is a number 2, so it is here, and then there is a 3 number like that. So 1, 2, 3, depending on your convenience, you please number that one. Now what you have to do, you have to take measurements at some equal intervals. So at initially, probably the water, if it is not, that means the stability, the water which is, that is it flux, the water which is coming out, so that will attain stability after some time. It may attain very quickly or it will take some time. So you have to give that much of time. So what you have to do is that you have to take a regular interval the reading. So suppose I am taking out one, this is for the demonstration I am telling you. So in this beaker, you find that there is some water which has been collected. So suppose this is for 10 minutes, the water collected like this. So Guru, please measure this. So now he is measuring with this cylinder, and what is the reading? Okay. The reading is 14. So that 14 ml or 14 centimeter cube, the water is collected, say for example, after a time period of say 10 minutes. So then you have to revert to the calculation. Just the calculation is very simple. So you have to apply the Darcy's law there. So the parameters which you need to record, that I am telling you. So what happens is, Raghubi, please, so I will explain that one. So we have a okay. Now please watch this instruction very carefully. So now this is the outflux. This is the out boundary, or you can say the water is coming out. And here it is the in boundary, that means this boundary through this water is coming in. So there is a height which is maintained. So what you have to do is that you have to first calculate the hydraulic height. So if you take this one, that means the bottom part of this core as the reference plane, then this one Z is 0. Now here the Z is the column height. Say for example the column height is 5 cm. So your Z is 5 cm. And your water which is there standing, so that height of water will be your, this is your positive pressure. So that positive pressure, which you can denote it as, say for example, you can denote it as P. So this P is, say, this is 3 centimeters. So 5 plus 3, it is at this particular boundary, which is the inner one, which is the in, that means through this water is entering into the soil. And then water is coming out through this, and here everything is 0, because that is the reference plane. So Z is 0, and as there is no standing water, you can find out. So here also your P is 0. So the difference is, so 5 plus 3, 8 is here, and 0 is here. So the difference is only 8. So the 8 is the hydraulic head difference. And you have this column length, but this is the 5 centimeters. So 8 divided by 5 gives you the hydraulic head gradient. And as per Darcy's law, the flux is proportional to the hydraulic head gradient. So your hydraulic head gradient is your 8 divided by 5, whatever value comes. So now you have to take the flux. So flux is what? Flux is velocity per unit of time.
So the time you are taking it as minute or second, whatever. So the velocity means you have collected 14 ml of water. That means it is a 14 centimeter cube. And you have the cross-sectional area through which the water coming. So this one is having certain centimeter square value. So you have to divide this centimeter cube by this centimeter square, so you will get centimeter. So that is the height of the water, or water, volume of water or water coming out expressed as head. So that's the velocity if you are taking it per unit of time. So the per unit of time, it will be your, so whatever amount of water which is collected divided by the cross-sectional area in centimeter square and divided by the time through which you have collected the sample. So that gives you the flux. So just simply you divide the flux divided by the hydraulic head gradient. So again, I am repeating that one. In a nutshell, what you have to do, you have to collect the water. You have to collect the water from the individual beakers or individual samples and then measure this. So in my case, one measurement is coming 14 meter cube, 40 centimeter cube. Then you need to have this hydraulic head difference. So how will you find it out? This is the in boundary where the water is getting inside the soil. So here you have, if it is the reference plane, so this is Z. So here it is say 5 centimeter. So the Z is 5. There is a pressure, water is there standing. So if that is 3 centimeter, so it is 5 plus 3, 8. So the 8 is the head here. And here the head is 0, hydraulic head. Because here the reference plane is 0, so Z is 0. And also there is no standing water, so the P is 0. So the difference is 8 minus 0. So it is simply 8. And you have the height of the soil column, so that is 5. So 8 divided by 5 is your hydraulic head gradient. And then you have the flux, which is 14 divided by the centimeter square area. This will give you the flux per unit of time by which you have taken the measurement. And then simply that flux you divide by your hydraulic head gradient, and you will get the hydraulic conductivity. Okay. So thanks. I thank Raghuveer also here, and then Sitesh is there. So they have helped me for demonstrating this one. Okay. So thank you. Once again, you see the set. Okay. So this is the reservoir from where water is coming. These are the sets, and then the water is being collected. Okay, thanks.